various sources are there. In those sources, mainly we will use two sources. The first one is Clydesdale source and another one is gun oscillator. First one is a Clydesdale source and another one is a gun oscillator. This source will convert a modulated signal into a microwave signal, whereas gun oscillator simply generates microwave signal. This source will convert a microwave signal into modulated signal into a microwave, whereas a gun oscillator generates a microwave signal. Like we have seen a function generator. The function generator is one type of oscillator. It is generating a sine, square, signals with a lower frequency. Similar to a function generator, this gun oscillator will generate microwave signals. In this Clydesdale, internally it will have a bunching cavity, catcher cavity. Based on bunching phenomenon, this source will generate a microwave signal. Whereas, internally this gun oscillator will have a gun diode. Based on the gun effect, this source will generate a microwave signal. After a source, we have to use an isolator. Why we have to use an isolator means this is a two-port device which transmits the signal only in a one direction. That is from port 1 to port 2. From port 2 to port 1, it doesn't allow any signal power. We are using an isolator to protect this source. For example, consider small scale applications. Like consider a tube light. It will work for a 12 volts input. If we give a 20 volts input, whether the tube light will work properly? No. Tube light doesn't work properly. It is a small application. Whereas this a microwave signal. We will use a microwave signal in a higher applications. If it receives a signal in this bad direction, it doesn't work properly. Its operation will vary. That's why, in order to protect this source, we are using isolator. This isolator simply transmits the signal, a microwave signal to the other end. Okay? After this, this is the fixed notation. Microwave source followed by isolator. Amplifying things. Attenuator, frequency meter, slotted eye section, PSW meter. This is all our wish. We can place these components at any position. These are not fixed. Based on our application. For example, if you want to measure a signal frequency, in that case, we will use only a frequency meter. Whenever we want to attenuate a signal, in that case, we will use attenuator only. Based on the application, these components will appear. The next thing is attenuator. When we will use this attenuator block is whenever we want to reduce the signal strength. In that case, we will use attenuator. Attenuators are of two types. First one is fixed attenuator and another one is variable attenuator. This fixed attenuator will provide a fixed amount of attenuation. How it is providing a fixed attenuation means, let us consider this as a waveguide. In this waveguide, in fixed attenuators, internally we have a dielectric slab. This is a dielectric slab. This is a dielectric slab. Because of this dielectric slab, this is providing attenuation. Here, whenever the wave is flowing in this waveguide, because of this dielectric slab, the wave gets absorbed in the testing now.
Wave meter and another one is a
9.2, 9.4, 9.6, 10.2, 10.4, 10.6. Internally, on the upper side we have a frequency values. Internally we have a peak, or else we can have a knob.
Whenever we want to observe the
thereby adding it up. Fixed means it will provide